Hello, everybody. Welcome back. Let's start with one of those right there. Here we go. So I'm here with Joss.
Hey, guys.
Thank you for being in my video.
Oh, no. Unbelievably my pleasure, sir.
Thank you. Yeah. Not everyone has said that. Unbelievably your pleasure.
Oh, well, it is. It truly is.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So we're going to do something fun today.
Yeah.
You know, there's a lot of talk about the Harley Benton cabinets, and they are just an incredible price with incredible feature.
Yeah.
You could, the cabinet, which is to your right, has 2x12 Celestion Vintage 30s, and it costs €200. I don't know what that translates where you are, but since we're in Germany, we're going to go with euros. €200. Actually, I think it's like €197, something like that. So I'm rounding off.
Okay.
€200 with Celestion Vintage 30s. Interestingly enough, that cabinet cost less than two speakers.
That is, yeah.
It's insane, right?
How does that even
exactly?
How does that even work? But that is, yeah, that's
crazy.
That is crazy.
And as we know, of course, the cabinet design and all that is very important, but the speakers are the key component to a speaker cabinet.
Of course.
And then we have the Mesa Boogie 2x12. I'm not sure exactly what model 2x12 it is, but it's a 2x12 with Celestion Vintage 30s.
It's a closed back one, isn't it?
Is it, Rich?
Yeah.
Fully closed back. I think they're both closed back.
Cool.
Okay. And the goal of this video, and that's about €1,000. Good video, right?
Yeah. Cool. Okay.
So we're going to compare the €200 to the €1,000 2x12 cabinets, and just, you know, let's have a conversation.
Yeah.
Is it, do they sound identical? If they sound a little bit different, is it, you know, is it saving 80% of the price? Is it, you know, is it worth it? That type of thing.
Yeah.
So that's the goal of this video. And weigh in the comments below. Let us know what you think. So where would you like to begin? Why don't we start with the, where would you like to start?
Where are we starting at the moment?
Right now we are on the, let's start with the Harley
Benton. Let's start with the Harley Benton, So I believe I'm, do you want me to start on a clean
sale? Yeah, let's do something clean.
Yeah, yeah.
We'll warm them up.
Of course, of course. So this is, I'm playing my 7 string. I've got a DiMarzio passive in the neck.
Beautiful. Cabinet, I like your playing.
Oh, thank you.
That sounds
much.
Great.
Thank
okay.
You.
Now, by the way, we are using the Hughes & Kettner Triamp Mark III, which is a
beast. An absolute monstrosity.
Yeah. So now let's do this. I'm going to put that on, turn that off, and now we are on the Mesa Boogie.
We are.
Now, for the viewer, that is a little closer to us, so it sounded a little bit more forward-facing.
Yeah, and there's a little bit more sort of top end to the sound in my ear, but yeah, that is because the other cab is sitting behind us. So.
What's the camera guy's name working the console?
Johannes.
Johannes, can you hear us? Can he hear us?
Yes.
I have a question for you. Are you hearing the same volume between both cabinets? Okay, good. So the reason why I wanted to ask the guy who's miking it up was because what we're hearing in this room may be different because they're both mic'd up.
Yeah, yeah. And the difference with it sitting that close and that one being behind, there is a
change. That 8 inches will make a big difference.
There's quite the change between the sounds. So, but it's good, as you said, it's mic'd up. So we're hearing the true representation of it anyway.
Yeah. So what we're hearing exactly in this room may be a tiny bit different. So our conversation may differ from what they hear on the playback. Because you're hearing the mic'd up. Both cabinets are mic'd up. Same mic, same everything, but for us, the placement is a little different.
Yeah.
But I would say clean channel, they both sounded great.
Sounded good. There's a lot of nice sort of biting top end to the tone. So, but when I hit the guitar hard, it doesn't go and hurt my ears. It's still smooth.
Okay. So let's go to a crunch channel, kind of halfway between here and there. And let's go back to the Harley Benton. So I'm going to do that and that, and now we're on the Harley Benton. Show off.
I was just watching my own hands and looking, going, oh, look how tiny my hands are.
Okay.
So disappointing.
Tiny hands. That sounds like we're getting into a political conversation. All right, let's go to the boogie.
Yeah.
The boogie sounds louder to me.
But that genuinely might be because it is there.
Okay.
I mean, or that is, if the cameraman was correct in saying that they are at the same volume, maybe that is the distinctive
difference.
Sound difference that we're hearing that gives you the sort of, not misconception, but the conception of that it's like louder because we're hearing, I don't know, more overtones or more harmonic content.
Mm-hmm. What's your opinion sitting over there? Did you hear a difference in volume?
I'm picking up the same stuff as what you guys are. I'm hearing a lot more top end from the mezzo.
Okay.
It does sound louder to me as well.
Okay.
And I'm wondering what the other differences are besides the speakers. Is the wood that they use somehow... Well, it must be worth...
I mean, you could get crazy front mount, rear mount, all different...
Yeah.
So let's do this. Play like a 3-chord something simple on the Mesa, then we'll go back to the Harley Benton.
Okay, cool.
Yep. Okay. They sound completely different.
They sound completely different in the room.
Yeah.
Yeah, that sounds far louder. There's far more upper, mid-range, and top-end harmonic content.
If I was sitting in a room, that feels like it's 5 feet away, and the Harley Benton feels like it's 20 feet away.
Yeah, yeah.
That's the best way I could describe it.
Yeah, I completely agree with that.
The difference with the last sample for me, it was almost like there was a blanket over the second cab.
Yeah, yeah, as if I'd need to turn...
It's a bit muffled. The volume difference from where I'm sat over here...
Hi, Rich.
...was huge.
Yeah, it's like the presence needs to be controlled more, like more top end needs to be brought in on the Harley Benton.
Yeah, yeah.
I know this sounds like a bad time to ask this question, but I hope we have the right cabinet back.
I mean,
it does say the Celestion, right? I mean, they only make the cabinet with a Celestion Vintage 30.
It says Celestian equipped.
Yeah,
so, yeah,
it's got to be the right cabinet.
It has to be.
Because it's not like we screwed the back off to verify.
Yeah, yeah, right. Exactly. No, I'm pretty sure it has to be with that badge.
And same thing with the Mesa. We specifically ordered the Mesa with Celestion Vintage 30s. Mm. But again, for full transparency, folks, we didn't verify.
Don't take the back off.
We didn't take the back off
to
verify.
No.
So there potentially could be room for error in our science experiment here.
Yeah, maybe. But if that's... We have to just trust the Tomans.
Absolutely. Just trust the label on the box and the badge on the front.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Hope that they said the right one.
All right. I was just trying to maybe explain why we're hearing such a huge difference.
I think the one way that we'll really hear a distinctive difference as well is I'm using a 7-string guitar, right?
Mm-hmm.
So if I play something down at the lower register... Mm-hmm. If the muffling on that turns the guitar to sort of a muddiness, then we really start to hear a distinctive difference between if that has a lot more mid-range and top-end to it, if you know what I mean.
So you want to do that?
Yeah, just quickly.
Okay, so we're right now we're on the Harley Benton.
This is the Harley Benton, and I'm in B standard, so nothing's tuned down.
Okay.
So there is still, it's still clear, there's still clarity there. If we change to the Mesa Boogie now.
Okay, hold on. We're on the boogie. Just sounds louder.
It just sounds louder, but the bottom end, I don't know if it's the top or the bottom end, but it makes me... Makes me want to dig in far more.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if that is because of the volume and me getting all like excited about it, but it makes me want to
interesting
gurn and dig in.
Okay. Let's change channels. Let's go on the lead channel.
Okay. So all I've done is, because I've backed the gain off on that, so I'm just going to engage the boost function.
And that's the lead. Okay.
Yeah, so it's like turning a, it's like pushing a tube screamer in the front end.
Okay. So I'm going to go back to the Harley Benton. Let's start there. And give us some notes, man.
Some whittle.
Throw some notes at us.
Throw some notes at her. Okay. I'll whittle away.
Now do that slow for everyone that wanted to learn that riff.
No, you have to go to a different channel for that one.
There you go. All right, so now I'm going to turn this on, turn that off, and here's the... Hopefully you remember what you played.
I do.
We're on the boogie.
Yeah.
Got the chainsaw out for that one.
Oh yeah,
it was like you were just chopping down a tree right there. Right, exactly. Yeah, yeah. Exactly.
I mean, in terms of lead characteristics of what I would like, yep. The Mesa Boogie just has more attack.
Mm-hmm.
This is quite a high output bridge humbucker.
Is that an X2N?
No, this is my good buddy Wes Houck's new signature Jupiter pickup with Seymour Duncan.
Sounds great.
Yeah, it's basically like a 7-string Dimebag pickup.
Gotcha.
So yeah, it's the attack that I need when you're doing the alternate picking stuff comes through more on the Mesa Boogie.
Right. Well, there it is. You got to hear two cabinets. One is 1,000 euros, the other one is 200 euros, same speakers, and... you know, I'm curious to see. I don't even really want to necessarily share my opinion because I need to hear the playback.
Yeah.
Because what we're hearing in a room, not positioned scientifically, I think I need to hear it mic'd up.
Yeah.
Same mics going into the same system.
With it being that
because my opinion might be completely different than what we're hearing here. Hey guys, so I just want to leave my opinion and my comment after listening to the playback of this video. It's interesting because when Joss and I were in the room, we heard a huge difference between the cabinets. Now, some of that may have to do with the cabinet placement, but it was a pretty big difference. That's why our conversation was what it was in regards to all the differences that we were hearing. After having heard the playback, they actually sound the same, which leads me to this conclusion. If you're miking your amp up, they sound the same to me on the playback. In a room, they sound pretty different, which is interesting. So there's my opinion. You got to hear our opinion in the room of the differences that we heard. And my opinion after listening to the playback is that they actually sound pretty close. And that's probably because they are the same speakers and the speakers are mic'd up. And you're hearing less of the nuance of the cabinet itself in this video. So there it is. Thank you.
I mean,
do you agree with that?
100%. Because if I was to give you my personal opinion now, it's obvious which one I would say.
Yeah.
It sounds completely different. But yeah, I need to hear it.
Because that just sounds a lot closer, a lot, you know.
Yeah.
But here's the question now. Is it 200 euro versus 1,000 euro.
So that's the thing. That is the other main thing.
So all things being equal, what we heard right now, do you spend 1,000 euro or 200 euro? Is that good enough at 200 euro?
I think so.
Okay.
200 euros is such an insanely small amount of money in the cab world.
Right.
And to have it be a 212 loaded with vintage 30s.
So that's not 800 euro better.
I need to hear it, Mike. I don't want to say it
right.
Because it feels wrong to say yes.
Right.
I don't know, because that Harley Benton still sounds killer to me.
Right.
But the Mesa Boogie just, my personal,
well, that's
just
why I said,
better.
Is it how much better?
Yeah,
is,
I mean,
it €800 better?
No.
Right.
I,
and that's, I'd be struggling. If it was like €200 or €400, I'd then, say,
sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But €800 better?
And I'm not spending €1,000 on a cabinet. I'm not doing it.
I mean, you know, you could throw money at a lot of things and everything will get better.
Mm-hmm.
But how much better?
Exactly.
Otherwise, we'd all be driving Ferraris and...
Exactly.
Right?
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Anyway, your opinion might be different because we're not hearing it mic'd up. So when the video is out, I may actually weigh in on the comments. It would be good if you to weigh in on the comments when we hear the finished product.
Yeah,
but
yeah, of course.
Hopefully you enjoyed this video of the Harley Benton versus the Mesa Boogie. And Josh, thank you so much for being in the video. Folks, thank you for watching. Leave you one of those, and we'll see you later.